Hello everyone, hope you are doing well. So in this video we will be seeing what is Ionic, how can we install it and how we can use different UI components in Ionic. So let's just switch to our browser and to begin with Ionic, we have Ionic framework documentation which contains different UI components and its usage. So let's just switch to our Ionic framework docs page and here we can see we have installation guide and UI components. First of all, let's just see what is Ionic framework. Ionic framework is an open source UI toolkit for building performant, high quality mobile and desktop apps using web technologies like HTML, CSS and JavaScript with integration for popular frameworks like Angular, React and Vue. So from this, it is clear that first of all, it is an open source UI toolkit. Second thing that it can be helpful for building high quality mobile and desktop apps. Then it contains HTML, CSS and JavaScript and we can use frameworks like Angular, React and Vue along with it. So after definition we will be switching towards its installation. So we have an installation guide over here which will guide us to install Ionic in our computer. So just scroll below and the first thing we are seeing is the install the Ionic CLI link and after that we will see that first of all we require Node.js installed in our computer and then just open your terminal and write this npm install code over here. I already have in my Ionic in my system, so I will not install it again. Then I will check that I already have the Ionic like this. I can check the version of Ionic and I also have Node in my system. I have npm as well. So this is the code for installing latest version of Ionic in your system. So let me clear that if you want to work with Angular or React, the older version will be, you can use them with older version, but for Vue, if you want to work with Vue framework, you require the latest version of Ionic. For that, you have to uninstall the previous version and install the latest version. So here they have provided the code for uninstalling the previous version and then installing the latest version. So you can write this code for installing the previous version and then you can write this code to install the latest version. After that, once your Ionic has installed successfully in your computer, we will be starting by creating an app for that. So for this, they have provided a code over here. It is actually the shorthand technique for creating the app. I will be demonstrating another technique which will demonstrate different steps for creating our app. So here we have to do Ionic start. This is the first step for creating or starting our app. So just click enter. Here now after that I have to choose the framework on which I have to work. So I want to work with Vue. So I will be clicking towards Vue. After that I will be providing a name. So I will be providing a name, my demo app. Then enter. Then they have provided some starter templates, tab, side menu, blank and list. Tabs, side menu and list already have components and some templates in it, but the blank is totally blank and it has minimal components, UI components of Ionic in it. So I am starting from scratch, so I will be using blank template for my app. So just click and the process of starting or creating the app will take some time, so just patiently wait for this process, and it will inform us once our app is created. As you have seen that we have a shorthand technique also. Here it means that Ionic start, this is the name which we have provided in the next step, project name, then starter template that we have chosen as blank. So this is the shorthand technique for starting an app. So this is the blank one, this is the tabs, this is the side menu. So as we can see that our first app, my demo app, is created. So I will go in the project by this command and will simply open this in my choice of editor, that is VS Code. Now we have our project already created. To run this, what we will do is I will open my terminal, and to run our app, just we have to do is Ionic serve. This is the code for running an Ionic . So this is what our blank template actually looks like. Let's just see its code. We can find it in our SRC, then views, and this is our home page. Just close the terminal, and here we can see we have a toolbar, then we have title. The UI components of Ionic have Ion before them. So this is Ion toolbar, this is Ion title, this is for first of all we have Ion page, then Ion header, inside that we have toolbar contains title, this is all inside header part, then we have content which has Ion again, then all this part, as we have discussed before that HTML, CSS and JavaScript are also in our Ionic. So this is the div, which is a tag of HTML, so we can use div as well. Then we have script, then we have some CSS properties over here. So this is how an Ionic view application page look alike. First of all we have a markup, after that we have script, then we have the styling or CSS portion for this. So that after this I will be switching towards the UI components. Here they have used a few. I will cover all the UI components or as much as I can to demonstrate how Ionic UI components actually work and how can we write script code for them and how can we apply CSS properties to them to make a high level desktop and mobile web application. So here I would like to end my this video, and in the next video I will be showing different UI components in Ionic and how can we use them with Vue framework.